Hello guys, welcome to Vahagraphy. In this video, we'll be comparing the Nikon Z50, a modern mirrorless entry-level camera, to a smartphone, in particular the iPhone 13 Pro. We'll be doing 4K 30 frames per second, and we'll compare results. Do these professional camera manufacturers need to concentrate on entry-level cameras for vlogging, or is the smartphone good enough for that application? Well, we'll do the test, and hopefully you can form your own opinion as to the results you see. The Nikon Z50 is an interchangeable camera. We'll be using the Nikon 16-50DX kit lens at its widest setting. I usually shoot on manual mode, however, for this test, just to make it fair, we'll put the camera to full automatic. After all, we do use an iPhone full automatic most of the time. Plus, I want to see how well it reads the colors, the white balance compared to an iPhone side by side when set on full auto on the camera. First plus with the real camera, ergonomics and handling. That's a given. You know, you're going to get really nice ergonomics with a real camera. Functionality as well, check mark to the real camera. However, for this video, let's focus on what entry-level users and vloggers really look for in a device that captures imagery like video, 4K video. This first test, smooth stabilized video handheld. This is side-by-side video action. I'm not using a gimbal. This is just handheld walking. As you can see, the iPhone is it's magic. I mean, it's holding its own. It's doing an incredible job. Nikon Z50 does not have internal IBIS. This lens that I'm using does have image stabilization. However, the iPhone just takes it here. It's smooth transition. You can walk and talk literally. You don't need a gimbal when using the iPhone. And also pay attention to the escalator, the lines. I like the Nikon Z50 image better. I think we're getting a little bit more of a moiré effect on the iPhone 13. As far as the lines go, the Z50 takes it there as far as that goes. For this next example, I want to show you guys HDR and AI computing when it comes to imagery. I'm not a big fan. I like the blacks on the Z50 better. I know that the iPhone shows you a little bit higher of a dynamic range with the HDR effect, but I'm not really a big fan of that. In this next example, I'm focusing in right on the glass of water. Look at the bokeh in the iPhone. And now let me switch over to the Nikon Z50. A lot more detail in the water. And I like the bokeh. It's pleasing to the eye with the Z50 results. So overall picture quality and motion. Let's zoom in here. Let's freeze the frame and zoom in here. The best way to describe the results here, the Z50, when it comes to video, is showing a little bit more of a filmic type result versus an iPhone, which is more digitized and digital looking. What do you guys think? Leave me a comment down below. So it was only fitting to take this review to an Apple store, right? Ha, the new screens and the new computers they have are just beautiful to look at. Anyway, this is iPhone 13 footage here. Natural light in the store. Overall, the image looks great for everyday vlogging and YouTube without any, you know, drastic low light conditions. You'll be fine with the phone. More on that a little later. And here's some Nikon Z50 footage. Same settings, same lighting. Full automatic mode, remember. Now here's where things get interesting. Acquiring focus, moving from shot to shot. Here I'm shooting it at 50 millimeters. Acquiring a tight shot on the Z50. This is when things are set apart. The iPhone 13, I'm using the portrait camera and I'm trying to, you know, do the same things with this footage, but you could see that the iPhone footage falls apart. It's not as crisp. It's not as pleasing to the eye. This is where the Nikon Z50 just reigns supreme. I mean, look at the footage. It's night and day really with shots like this. And the iPhone 13 did a better job on cinematic mode. As you see here, the footage does look better. The bokeh is more pleasing. However, the Z50 acquiring focus, moving from object to object, you could see that the Z50 did a better job than the iPhone. And sometimes you had to press the iPhone, the object on the iPhone screen to acquire focus. Here, it would not do it, even if I was pressing it. But the Nikon Z50, as you could see, moving from object to object, just does a better job acquiring focus. And the picture does look that much better. The proof is in the pudding. And also having a real zoom lens that you can actually control with your hand has its advantages. As you see here, the transitions look good to me. The camera is on full auto and it's adjusting settings because this is an aperture, a variable aperture lens. Now here again, the Z50 is full auto, so is the iPhone out of the box. Skin tone natural light test. I am spinning and the directional light is changing. The settings do change here. Just wanted you to see the side-by-side comparison of both. Rolling shutter effect, iPhone 13 Pro, and of course, the Z50. What do you guys see? In this next test, this is where zooming is just night and day. You're talking about a real zoom lens you can actually control with your hand, like I said. And here are the results. You can actually see the camera adjusting settings on the fly as you zoom in and out. It's a real zoom lens. Now, on the iPhone, you can zoom. It does shift from camera to camera, but it's not as smooth. The results are not great. It's not like having a real zoom lens you can control with the palm of your hand, of course. And the transitions are not pleasing. I can tell when it shifts from camera to camera, as you see here. It's just not usable when you're doing something that's, critical. And if you want something to come out smooth, and when you're zooming, the Nikon Z50, like you see here, does a way better job. Okay, so smooth transition and finding focus. Cinematic mode, I find the iPhone 13 did a good job. Here I'm going back and forth from the wall to the Apple logo. As you see here, it does an okay job, pulling focus. It's not perfect. Again, this is portrait mode. Now on the Z50 side of things, I'm shooting it at 50 millimeters. It does a better job acquiring focus to the Apple logo. However, when I went back to the wall, it took some time to figure out that I need focus on the wall. And there it is. Practicality, functionality, and use case. These things to think about when choosing what to use on your next project, your vlog, because in some ways the iPhone 13 does an excellent job, and other ways the Nikon Z50 just blows it out of the water. Just depends. We are testing the audio. How would it work if you're doing vlogging with both systems, iPhone or Nikon Z50? This is the Nikon Z50 right here. The audio, check, 1, 2. The audio is set on automatic on the Nikon Z50. On A mode, the mic settings, and the iPhone is already automatic. So this is the iPhone. iPhone, mic check 1, 2, 3. Mic check 1, 2, 3. And the Nikon Z50, mic check 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3, Nikon Z50 mic. iPhone, testing 1, 2. Testing 1, 2. Hey, by the way guys, on the mic test footage, there was a little bit of wind, which is a good thing because I wanted you to see the difference when talking about wind noise. All right, we're at Ferrari, my favorite car of all time. I'm gonna be switching from camera to camera here so you can see the difference, the colors and what you see, the lighting and on all that good stuff. I love this car, I love this brand. I think this brand is just a phenomenal auto car, sports car maker. My dream car for sure. Look at that red one right there. However, some of you guys might be thinking, well, why is the Z50 footage wider than the iPhone sometimes? When switching to the iPhone wide angle camera, it's just too wide for the test. So what I thought was, let me just put it on the middle camera on the iPhone and just have the Z50 lens as wide as it could go. And by the way, did you see that desk? I want that desk, that Ferrari front receptionist desk. That's really cool, man. Yeah, guys, one day, huh, guys? Let me hit the lotto. So to conclude, is there a clear winner in all of this? Well, my conclusion is they are different. Use case is very important in this situation, which one to use. I think for practicality purposes, we all have our smartphones on us all the time. The best camera is the one that's with you, right? But in a lot of circumstances, the real camera will win most of the time. Now you might like the iPhone 13 footage. If you like that HDR digital effect, by all means. For me, I'm not a big fan. I like the look of the Nikon Z50 better. The blacks are richer. I guess if you're a vlogger that wants something that has a little bit of a Steadicam effect, the iPhone is the way to go. But if you're doing a lot of things in low light, I would not suggest the iPhone. Hey, what's good guys? Vahagan here from Vahagraphy. If you like more photography rocking content like this one, go ahead and check out the videos on the screen and subscribe to this channel for more exclusive content.